Hi. have to make it shorter. Can you? Okay. Can we all be in the same line? Can we all be in the same line? Is the room big enough?
Yes, it is.
Okay. So we would like you, one by one, to share with us what you would like these curtains to have behind them. And to make sure that everybody listens, I suggest that we all repeat each person's sentence. So, for example,
I wish that there was a beach behind these curtains.
I wish that there was a beach behind these curtains.
I wish that there was a rainforest behind these curtains.
I wish that there was a rainforest behind these curtains.
Ich wünsche mir frische Luft.
Ich wünsche mir frische Luft.
Can you
translate for us?
Fresh air.
Okay.
I want to be a rain of stars in the middle of August.
I want to be a rain of the stars in the middle of August.
I would like to have food behind the curtain.
I would like to have food behind the curtain. Okay, just a moment. Okay.
I wish there was a galaxy
behind these curtains.
I wish there's an open window with a nice breeze coming in behind the curtain.
I wish there was an open window with a nice breeze behind these curtains. I wish there is another room behind the curtains. I wish there were colors behind these curtains.
I wish there were pets behind this curtain.
I wish there were pets behind this curtain. Sorry?
Pets.
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 I see a white wall and a Buddha statue behind the curtain.
I see a white wall and a Buddha statue behind the
curtain.
I also wish there was food behind these curtains. I wish there was nothing behind these curtains.
I wish my loved ones were behind these curtains.
I wish my loved ones were behind these curtains.
I wish there would be some water behind this curtain.
I wish that there would some be
I wish the moonlight behind this curtain.
I wish the moonlight behind this curtain.
I wish there was an orchestra behind the curtain.
I wish there was an orchestra behind the curtains.
I wish there's a beautiful sunset behind the curtains.
I wish there is a beautiful sunset behind the curtains.
I wish there were an apple which I can eat behind the curtains.
I wish there was something.
Ah, there is something to eat.
Yes, an apple.
I wish there was something to eat behind the curtains.
I wish there would be a wonderful waterfall behind this curtain.
I wish there would be a wonderful,
wonderful,
wonderful, wonderful.
I wish there will be some flowers behind that curtain.
I wish there would be some flowers behind these curtains.
I wish there will be another curtain behind the curtain.
I wish there would be another curtain behind the curtain.
We form a circle so we don't see each other, we see each other.
Because I thought that gray is kind of sad color, and maybe it would be more interesting to see a colorful curtain. Red, black, green, blue.
Sorry, I can't hear you.
I'd like to exit door.
Refreshing.
But not.
No.
people who ask for food behind the curtain, are you less hungry now? You're not more hungry now. I don't know who asked, several people asked. You're more hungry?
Sorry, can you share some feedback with us before you go? Sorry? Okay. Okay, so let's try to say what we would want to do.
Now?
Yeah.
To sit.
I want to drink something.
Is there any way anybody has water or something to give to this thirsty lady? Yeah. Entschuldigung, ein Moment.
Dazu würde ich sagen, wir haben noch 10 Jahre.
much.
Thank you. It's not your fault, it's mine. Bye.
Stay that long, enjoy the music.
It reminded me of the one pleasure I really get from being in a church or any building with a tremendous elevated space, because the music, the acoustics, it really lifts the interest to the top. So that's one of the nice pleasures of, I guess, being in that setting. It's the most pleasure I can get being a non-religious person in a religious building, when I hear the sound coming from the sky, like your song. Yeah, I don't know how long this will last. I'm a little bit, I guess I'm getting some pleasure from trying to figure out what this is about. I think you may be right, it's about the embarrassment or non-embarrassment of leaving early, because it's always at the beginning, don't leave. Just try to stay. No one wants to stay for an hour really, unless they have to. I guess that's it. You feel what's going on?
I like dancing, that's why I would like to dance
soon.
If there's more music.
We can try that.
Okay. Same music.
You can continue singing.
Okay, so
we should start.
Let's say who's
And let's use this line as a dividing line. And I would like to ask people that are enjoying this concert so far, go from this side. And people that are not enjoying this concert so far, go on that side. Okay. And now I would like people from each group to ask anything, questions, people from the other group, in order to understand why they position themselves in this group.
See what's happened, like if there's still something happening or not.
Really enjoy the time here because I'm not able to understand English very well, so I, you know, it's difficult for me.
I enjoy it really because I have to stand in this place. And I'm hungry.
Is there something that keeps you from moving around or from sitting down?
Yes, because you have to stand in a circle, so I'm standing in a circle.
But they sat down.
You could have sat down as well.
Please? They sat down, so you can sit down,
yes,
down if you want as well.
It's cold or it's better. Mm.
So I would like to ask you, what is that you like in this concert?
Oh, I can decide if I'm enjoying myself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I like it. It's new.
You didn't come up with a Beatles song to maybe make us all enjoy singing together a bit more. So I blame it on him.
I'm not enjoying it.
That's a good one. I think we can sing all the one. I'm definitely not a singer. I don't know what I'm doing.
To ask all of you, is it enjoyment that makes you stay, or is it curiosity that makes you stay? Is it important for you to enjoy yourselves, coming to documental, or exploring something that's weird, at least?
It's maybe a little bit of politeness, because there was not even more than 1 second of a chance to make a reasonable decision on the conditions we're in. It was said as soon as we entered, oh, there's no way to leave, so it's sort of a politeness to stay here, because otherwise, if everybody would leave,
say, oh, I don't have an hour, then we wouldn't be no performance. So we all probably stay here because we're polite. And I don't know if anybody knew it would take 1 hour of precious time if you're only here for 1 or 2 days and you have many, many plans that you want to see. So I decided, okay, it's like you're being stuck in a traffic jam. Just enjoy it. That's my new possible stuff.
Well, when you're stuck in the traffic jam, you're going somewhere. You know you will reach your destination in the end, and this
we
is where you went.
It. As today, we have plans which we now have to cancel. We don't talk about it. It's just that's the way it happens. It's sort of fate.
But you don't seem to enjoy yourself so much.
Oh well, I do. As it is new to you. Normally, I don't like it if people decide what I'm supposed to do if I have certain plans. But it's sort of a vacation mode I'm in. So going to the documentary. So okay, this is a new way to see the documentary. Not looking at the work of art, taking part in it. So completely unprepared, but I enjoy it.
I have also a question. Do you enjoy contemporary art in general?
Yes. That's why we're here. I'm on the less happy side, but mild, because there's one part of this which I do enjoy very much, which is it is a difference from most of the other experiences of the few days I have here, which is to see things at my choice and move on and move away or stay as I choose. This is, although I chose to come in here, I'm sort of, as you say, stuck by politeness or social niceties. But it's good because it's more active. I shouldn't say active. But it's not as passive as most of the experiences of documentary allows you to just sort of skirt through a lot. I mean, hundreds if not thousands of works. This is forcing you to slow down and participate in some odd way. So I like that difference, but I'm not happy with the actual substance, but I'm happy with the difference from other things.
If I was to tell you that, let's take you three as an example, but anybody else, I release you from the politically correct position of being polite to us, to this place, and leave with no problem, no questions asked, leave right now. Would you leave? If I told you that actually, it's not polite to tell us that you're being polite by staying here, so white paper, you can go away. As you wish, no problem. Would you leave?
I'm still full of hope that I don't know you, but you are responsible for something. So now it's getting more interesting, I think, after this open speech of various people.
You don't feel yourself responsible. You don't feel yourself responsible. No.
Quite happy.
Yes. You feel yourself responsible?
Well, in participating, I think it's a performance. I'm supposed to be here. I think we might. Well, there be questions asked, so sometimes I think you might want to answer something, or want to say something, or want to do something, just to have. A nice gathering of people. In this way, I think I feel, yes, a little bit responsible.
Mm-hmm. I found it interesting at the moment you have to look another in the face, mm-hmm.
And from that moment you want to stay here because you have a little contact with another, and the whole day you are always going around and nobody look at you and you look nobody else. So it's the first moment for this day you look another people in the eyes, and so you have a little bit community, so a feeling of community. So I'm here staying.
Obwohl ich hungrig bin.
Can I suggest how beautiful it can be? Can I suggest what would be a beautiful ending to this? If, as we walk out in the procession up the ramp, so what's your name? Your name? What?
Francisca.
Francisca would lead us, or, you know, in a solo performance that resonates through the whole space. Maybe Amazing Grace would be good. So that people wonder what the hell's going on as we walk out. Understanding on my part, I thought I was going to be watching a dance performance or some kind of performance. I didn't realize this is a participation, and I was, you know, it's at 6 o'clock. I'm very, very tired, very, very hungry. If it came at, you know, 11, I think, you know, I have a different experience. Just a different time of day.
Did you have your desires met when, from what you experienced? The desires you have, the expectations, were they met from the experience in this room? And yet you're from this side of the room.
There was no time to develop the expectations. Somebody opened the door, we were just standing in front of the door by accident. Perform begins now. Last chance to get in.
I would like to ask you, would you like to share with us why you're standing over there?
Thank you. cannot hear.
I don't know. Maybe.
Expectations for this experiment failed. What are you expecting from us?
Well,
this kind of performance. I was being warned about the German audience. No, but honestly, to begin with, it's a different space. In Athens, we had much more warmer space. This has this experience for me, psychiatric. For most people, is ecclesiastic. It's something more religious. And it creates different feelings for everybody, for us, as well as for the audience. To be honest, I don't believe that our expectations were met, but something more important and more interesting came out of what we tried to do. So, all in all, I do believe that the energy was good, there was participation. Even this part of the room did participate, did interact with us and with the others. The point of this performance, for me at least, it may be called social dissonance, and we need to, as you have read, I suppose, to raise the social subject, but I don't think that an hour is enough. But I do think that for people who make a choice to come into this room, it, and even though maybe the choice wasn't so, I do believe that today we managed to be honest in this room, in a level of politeness, and to create connections, which, if we go out in society, it would be much harder. In this room, in Documenta, in an art space, it was safer, it was maybe easier, but it's not a given. I've been here 3 days, and it's not a given that it's going to happen. And today, I do believe it happened.
I find it interesting sometimes when people stay, even without enjoying themselves, just out of curiosity. Of course, it is very logical if you think about it, but when you spend some time in a performance space, you want to see what's going to happen, how it's going to end, to have the whole experience. So you stay and you engage, and this is good. But generally, that's why I also asked it, I have this feeling from the audience here that the whole exhibition really tortures them. I mean, they come and, for example, like today, I feel that they are very tired or hungry or thirsty, or they want to sit down, or they understand that the whole day they go like that and they don't see anybody or speak to anybody, and it has been mentioned again. So my question is, why do we do stuff that we don't enjoy? For example, nobody has to watch contemporary art. Nobody has to watch everything in Documenta. It's not, you don't have to do it, I mean. And yes, but still the question is, what makes us happy if the procedure doesn't make us happy? And so this is a part of what we are doing here, and this is a part that we see the mediations that we have in our everyday life. For example, maybe the whole day is tiring, maybe the procedure is not so enjoyable all the time, but there is this image for us that we want to fulfill by doing this, I guess.
make choices that would actually make me happy, or to express myself. Or, I mean, we are in this situation right now, and of course there is a very big frame about which directs us on the way we should act, like you said, like it's not polite to get out, or it's not polite to say, I don't know. Like the political correctness is getting very strong to the point that at some point I felt today that I could not do anything in fear of how it may be interpreted. Because inside this space things are interpreted in many different ways. It's like every action we do comes under the microscope, and then it can be amplified to a thousand different interpretations. So speaking for myself, and by being here and being a performer to this concert, I feel that I'm being instrumentalized.
Difference.